In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can patch devices. A device could be a moving light, a scroller, or a LED fixture, for example. Patching of devices is done in the patch menu just like all other patch commands. So I go to menu, I choose my patch, I choose patch devices, and in there I choose patch wizard, because this is the easiest way for me to find different manufacturers and devices. There is an extensive library inside your SmartFade ML, and most brands are accommodated, and models, and modes. And also, if you can't find a specific moving light inside the library, you can create your own personalities, and this is described in the Chapter 2 of the User Manual. First of all, I'm going to patch two ETC revolutions. So, with the left wheel here, I try to find the manufacturer, which is ETC. And to the right, I use the wheel number 3 to find the actual model. Now I have two ETC lights, and they are RWM/SMs. I can see the footprint over here. It requires 31 control channels, or DMX outputs. And I say yes to that. Then I go into the next step, which allows me to assign them to specific device channels. So I start with device 1, universe 1, DMX channel 31, because this is the address of that specific light. And I have 2, so I say the count is 2, which means I'm going to need 62 outputs. When I hit yes now, this is what I'll patch. The console asks me if I'm sure, and I say yes. Now these are patched. I'm going to patch 4 more lights, and then I'm going to show you how you can tell that they're patched, okay? So I go back out one step, I choose a different make, and I'm going to choose Mac 300s in mode 4. Always refer to the user manual of your actual moving light to find out what mode it's in and how many channels it needs. Mac 300 mode 4, it has a footprint of 13 outputs. When I hit yes, I'm back into the patch menu. It's starting to count from 3 because that's what's free now. And I'm going to set the first one to DMX output 101 because that's the address. 101. And I'll tell my SmartFade ML that I have 4 of these. So I'm going to be using a footprint of 52 outputs. When I'm done patching devices, I can exit with the exit key. If I want to see the device, how they're patched and that they're patched, I hit the device select key. All the keys that have, all of the 24 keys that have a device assigned to them in the patch will light up dimmed. I can choose it. And in the parameter mode of faders, I can turn on the intensities. These are my revolutions. I have pan and tilt on the wheels. In the same way, I can select my Mac 300s and bring up the intensity. And by the way, if you want to just quickly double check what is patched to a specific device, just hold down that key. And as I hold down the key, the display will show which device it is, universe and address, and the make and the model. It's a very fast way to find out what is patched to a specific device key. Now remember, if a particular device does not appear in the patch devices menu, you need to build a personality for it. That's a different tutorial.